week, we welcome Willow Robinson to the canteen. Hailing from the Welsh Valleys, guitarist Willow Robinson's musical journey has led him from London to the deserts of California, nurturing his voice through necessity and developing a songwriting style steeped in blues, rock, and folk. We are going to talk about his musical journey, his discovery of Mexican burritos, and we top it all off with a classic American ice cream sundae. Willow, thank you for coming. Welcome to the 5DB Canteen. Food's sort of what I really want to get onto, but I'd like to talk a little bit first about your sort of musical journey, how you came to be a musician, how you, you know, how you found your sound. Did you grow up being influenced by music at home, or did you just suddenly decide to pick up an instrument?
At a pretty young age, I think I started like piano at school and then classical guitar, because my parents were like kind of forcing me into the kind of creative route somewhat, because my mum's an artist and my dad is a writer, so they were very much like...
You had no choice.
Yeah, they're like, if you want to be a lawyer, you can get out. Like, you will play guitar. But yeah, and I grew up in Wales, so it was like very rural and remote, so I literally had nothing to do besides...
Play to the sheep.
I just absorbed myself into music, and my mum and dad were both very into music. They were always like vinyls playing, and then I kind of got introduced to like Led Zeppelin and around like 13, and my mind just exploded into these kind of like ideas of what I could become when I was an adult. I was always like steadfast, like, I'm going to be a musician. I knew the moment that I got a guitar that I was just like, this has to be the path.
And from being sort of guitar player, did you like to sing from the beginning, or was that something that came?
No, not at all. I was always just wanting to be like a lead guitar player. I kind of fell into singing initially just out of necessity, because I lived in the middle of nowhere and I had no singer, so I just started to like mumble into a microphone, and it was like horrendous. Like, I don't know.
Well, it's evolved pretty far considering your voice now. And then from your sort of upbringing on the Welsh borders, sheep, forests, and then moving to LA must have been a pretty jarring.
Yeah, when I was 19, I was trying to maybe go to music school in England, and the one that I wanted. I turned up to the interview, like, the night before. I was just, like, recklessly stupid at the time and, like, had a bit of a bender on the night before. Turned up to the interview.
The joys of youth.
Yeah. And I pretty much just, like, did a really horrendous interview. Like, I forgot what the questions were during the interview and I don't know. I was just completely out of it. So my first choice in England, I didn't get in. And then, so I was kind of looking around for another option, and there was this college in L.A., so I went there for a little bit, kind of fell into a band and did some touring, and
Just thinking a little bit about having grown up in Wales, moving to LA, you know, that fast-paced kind of city, what kind of food did you end up leaning to that you really enjoyed, but being vegan?
I went out there basically to record these four EPs, the season EPs, with these two producers, and they had this, like, this little hole-in-the-wall Mexican spot that we used to drive by before we go to the studio and get these, like, fiery hot burritos. Initially, I could barely finish one because it was like sweat and horrendous. But then I kind of became accustomed to this like extreme spice. And so we'd eat these.
It's a pretty dense thing, a burrito.
It's kind of like the perfect meal. Like, it's contained in itself. It's not like you don't need cutlery or anything. So when you're like moving, and it's great. You can just eat it with your hands.
Sort of all food groups are represented within that nicely wrapped little shimmery, foily.
Yeah, it's great. And I love bread, so it has the tortilla, and so I'm pretty much ticking all the boxes with that. On tour, we had this like tally where we tried to eat like 100 burritos in like 3 weeks. I think I ate like 30, like two a day or something.
That's a lot of beans though.
It was a lot of beans. Yeah, you know, it was not.
That might not be the
tour
best.
Bus was like a hot box of hell.
That's it. What's Willow's dream burrito?
It's kind of just like beans, corn, guacamole, lettuce, salsas, and then sometimes they have like plant-based meat kind of alternatives.
Bit of chili, do you like it spicy?
Yeah, super spicy, like as hot as possible.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I want my whole mouth to be like melting.
Great, so we'll give you food, you'll have your mouth on fire, you won't be able to sing anything.
Well, yeah, I don't know, but before
it's
sing,
like a
I
red line and... around here. Yeah.
My lips will be huge. Yeah.
So I think that could work really well. I think Mexican vibes, burrito, the burrito of all burritos.
Yeah.
No, I think that would be a great, I think that'd be a great meal.
Great.
To make Willow's dream burritos, we begin by making and pressing our own tortillas. A host of fresh ingredients will be used to fill the burritos for Willow's guests. The essential guacamole, sour cream and chives, spicy pulled chicken for the meat option, black beans, sweet corn, rice, caramelized onions, a delicious spicy salsa, cheese, parma ham, freshly chopped salad, and finally, some chipotle sauce. The burritos will be served with additional dips, tortilla chips, and another squeeze of chipotle.
Welcome to the 5DB Canteen. Thank you so much for coming. Now, if everybody could please put your hands together for Willow Robinson.
Thank you so much for coming, guys.
My nearest and dearest, bar a few, but it's amazing to be playing to familiar faces again after coming back from America for so long. Anyway, this is called Hope. Yes.
I think I'll take the long way on. Red wine and cigarettes will keep me warm. My eyes are tired, it's so damn cold. Is that my breath or just my smoke? Know there's something about tonight. The smell of coffee and city lights. It's too late to turn back now. I guess I could be in a worse town. And I'm saying, hey, I know it's labor, I got nowhere else to go. And hey, it's a little too late, but I still think it's beautiful. Used to know a girl out here. I haven't seen her in years. It's too late to turn back now. I'm standing right in front of her house. And I'm saying, hey, but I got nowhere else to go. Hey, it's a little too late, but I still think you're beautiful. But it's so damn cold. It's so damn cold. Just tell me. some wine and I'll sweet talk you on, you know. Light up the fire, oh, I sleep on this floor and I sweet talk you, woman, all night long. 'Cause it's so damn
this sort of beautiful Willow's burrito, what would be your go-to dessert to kind of finish that off?
Probably a sundae, ice cream sundae. Or a creme brulee, either of those. But I've never had a good vegan one, so maybe that's the challenge, you guys.
That's the challenge.
I don't know.
But I'm thinking about this, the sort of sundae in its own standalone sort of thing. What would be the layers of that sundae?
I like just simplicity, like really. Just vanilla ice cream is like my go-to. Chocolate brownie and sauce. Chocolate sauce. Stir it in.
Sprinkled on top.
Yeah.
Some nuts, maybe.
Maybe some.
Little cherry.
Put it all in.
Yeah.
Except for, don't put that much in, just vanilla ice cream and brownie.
Put it all in, but actually don't.
Put it all in.
How are you guys doing? You're right. Wonderful. Thank you.
I was literally like living out in the desert. I spent about a year there recording, and you can't really get much. There's no really good food.
Must have been really inspirational though. I mean, I can imagine for your songwriting.
I mean, it was just such like a different vibe in terms of the environment. You know, suddenly here it's so humid and lush and there's rain all the time, and suddenly it's just like so dry, just hot every day, and it's literal desert, cactus everywhere, and it's just like...
That's
just
when you need your tequila, lime and ice.
Right. Right? Yeah, I got introduced to that by a friend because that was all they drank, and I started having it. We'd like hang out and that's what they'd drink, so I started to get the taste for it. And
perfect.
Once I got the
simplicity.
Taste, I was like, oh, it's really hard to unravel yourself from that one.
You never let me touch your skin, even when I grow so never let me run my fingers through your hair. I lie beside you in despair, my darling. I'm calling, calling out to you, babe. I'm falling, falling, falling from you, girl. I'm crying, crying over you. I don't even want to know why you are so blue. You're down, I'm high. Well, I swear that I could see myself floating on by. Never have the light shone so dim. I guess they always fade, but yours never in my eyes. Can you compile me a list of reasons that you can give me for leaving? My darling, I'm calling, calling out to you, babe. I'm falling, falling, falling from you, girl. I'm crying, crying, crying over you. Yeah. I don't even want to know. Floating on by, love's a hard thing to balance, so maybe won't get it just right. But for now, I'll just tell you
Thank you so much, guys. Love you all, literally. So many beautiful, familiar faces. Thank you so much to 5DB. You guys, honestly, the loveliest team of people. And thank you for welcoming us all. These guys nailed it. Anyway, thank you so much. Lots of love.